You're trying to wrap my leg up. I'm gonna feed you one of my legs, okay? And I'm gonna wait for you to wrap it up. It's fine. Come on. You don't have too much. All my weight's on top of you. So I'm removing these things on your leg. If the feet are wrapped up on your leg, wrap up the foot, like the next log or something like that. Look, all of these feet go down. You push the foot into the person's face. That makes the hip elevate off the floor, see? And then you can't move. Yeah. See? You'd be in a very uncomfortable position.
Yes, in the last move, when you brought your opponent forward and you trapped him, what's his next move, the guy that's just been trapped? Because he knows that you're going to sweep him and then it's going straight into the headlock. So how can he anticipate an escape from there?
Don't let me hold your neck. Once that neck is trapped with the arm, it's not difficult. It's difficult to resist.
Yeah.
Because you're like this, right? Yeah. How can you bring that arm back? I'm holding it behind the shoulder, next to the shoulder. My head is off the floor. I have that nice and trapped. I'm not saying that's impossible. Obviously, it's not. But it's tricky. You would have to wait. I would suggest wait for the re-roll and then try to escape before the person dismounts to finish you in that, because once that grip is made and it's locked up, there's ways of doing it. Maybe going forward, there's probably ways that we can try to sort it out. But
it looked such a good move, and an escape very difficult. I thought I had to ask a question.
The move is sound. Maybe trying to balance the weight towards one side and the other, knowing what the next step is. There's always a way.
Thank you.
There's always a way. But don't let that get that close to the person underneath.
Well, sure. Thank you.
So in half guard.
To stop this arm, and this one I'm going to trap and secure your tricep with my shin. Look, see, it's what I'm aiming to do is to open this elbow of yours to try to get your back, and trying to avoid this one by holding the wrist, which is not always possible. The problem with this is we're very close. You're gonna have to get distance, yeah? Look, and I can start using my feet. I'm not gonna stay there, here in the half guard, trying
to sweep you,
in the half guard with you punching my face. No, okay. I'll try to drop one, and I'll try to hold.
From that few months.
Yeah. This is very important. and it works a lot. See?
And then even from a normal half guard like Pastor Robert here, you're going to bring you to God as well.
I will try to hold you here at this point. Look.
Ah, I see.
I have to get this heart and trap it. This one is not doing much. And I'll try to do the same thing. I'll try to bring it here, look. See? I'll trap you. Try to hold you here as much as I can. If you even apply a lot of strength to get this arm out, when you do so, you give me the space that I need. I'll try to put it around like that.
Okay.
Feet, push. Boom. Healing face. Okay. Works a lot. Yeah. Especially if you want to grow yourself to that. Yeah. Boom. Very useful. Yes, sir.
I wanted to know your thoughts about training intensity, like how hard should someone roll, balancing injuring yourself, or training, overtraining. Just your thoughts on how someone should, intense they should train or roll. Well,
it depends on what you want. Right? Are you training to compete? You're training just to train to keep your body on a reasonable level of activity. Depends a lot. If you're training intensely for any kind of competition, it's different. It's a totally different ballgame. Then you need other stuff. The training itself just won't do you. Need physical activity, you need workout, you need other stuff to help you get through your training session. Otherwise, I'm going to. And other than that, if you're just training to feel good, you know, like anything in life requires just a little bit of balance. Never leave the gym with an empty tank entirely. And try to keep a balance, overdoing it and not be able to move the next day. There's not much point in that. And training specifically, that's what makes you better. Specific training, studying positions, sparring wisely. Try to pair up with people that, you know, the difference in weight is not that great otherwise. Well, it's not like you get beaten every day. You want to beat up?
That's only once a week.
Can you please share with us your worst point in your career, like you learned from it?
Well,
there were no bad things.
I think any time in your life that you have to overcome any kind of difficulty that life puts in your way, which eventually happens to everybody, is the persistence and the way what you can get out of that bad experience. You know, what are you going to do with what you learn from it? You have to learn from your bad experience. Otherwise, you're going through life with nothing. So, I don't know. You just keep on going. What are you going to do? Learn and move on the best way you can. In Jiu-Jitsu, Luckily, I never had like serious injuries. I've broken bones or nose, wrist, ankles, but nothing that serious that I had knee injuries or shoulder injuries. I always protected myself a bit. You can't overdo it, otherwise some injuries are hard to overcome. But I don't know how to answer your question. I think I
I guess my question is related to season. What's, in your opinion, your best way to kind of keep continuing and avoid injuries? Do you do something outside of jiu-jitsu, like go over weight training?
A little bit of weight training, yeah. It's important. It protects your joints. You know? We're always twisting and turning our bodies in really weird ways. Some of us, because jiu-jitsu hasn't been in this country that long, it has been, and there's a lot more kids doing it, but most of us started training as adults, right? And not always you're used to rolling over your neck or twisting over your shoulder or having somebody sitting on you. Or these things are tricky. So I think, you know, preserve yourself. Sometimes people let ego get in the way. Or I knew a guy in New York that he told Enzo, oh, he was an engineer. Everybody said, oh, that guy doesn't tap to get it to him. Doesn't tap to get it to him. So Enzo goes, grabs his neck, squeezes it, and he like collapsed on the floor, fainted. And he does it again. The same thing happens like 2-3 times. And man, you told me you didn't have to get there. Yeah, I don't tap. Yeah, but you're sleeping every time. Well, what's the point? So you're gonna faint every time somebody grabs your neck? That's a bit weird solution. let you know, protect yourself. Sometimes the position is too tricky. There's always payback. Is this? Yes, sir.
So, I'm always talking about jiu-jitsu and friends. And the people I meet, I try and find a way to put it into the conversation. I try and talk about the benefits, how much fun it is. Every time I do that, people think I'm insane. How do I overcome this gap between us crazy people and the normal people outside? How do you do that?
You gotta bring them in.
Yes, bring them in.
It's very, very difficult to explain this to an outsider. The impression that people have with martial art is something very strict. In most cases, requires a lot of yelling. Jake's a black belt. They do a lot of yelling. And they have no idea what grappling is till they can actually feel it. I think you have to bring them in. Or grab them on the lawn of your house. Just don't scare them up too much.
Things
that I was very simple. I beat the crap out of him until I couldn't anymore. And then he started beating the crap out of me. And that was awful. It still goes on to this day. It's not a very pleasant experience at all. You'll have to find God and love and experience that when they feel something. Oh man, yeah. Well, I think when he was purple belt or so, I was alone. Embarrassing. Yes.
What age did you start sparring with him? Were you about 100%? His age?
Oh. It's your son. You never really go 100%. Sometimes you get a position that you know that's really bothering him, like the neon belly or whatever, and then you hurt him a little bit, but not you don't overdo it, or I'm not going to spar with my son and try to choke him on his jaw or anything like that. No, there's a certain level to it, but it was hard training in the sense that I wouldn't alleviate in a position. If I got a mount, I'd get the mount, and yeah, he would struggle to get out. But as I said, payback is awful. Now he does it worse than me. Yeah, he says it's payback. I don't remember what for.
You said to me, you said, be nice to Josh.
Be nice to Josh. Yeah, you said that payback is awful.
He's smiling, he's waiting. Hey. He's waiting over there.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, he'll come. Oh, no. Can we take a photo?
Yeah.
Oh, you
reading?
Huh?
Reading?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. Okay, how do you want to do it? Do you want to just sit everyone there?